Now, you walk up to a building like this, you have no idea. And that's probably the point. It's about as nondescript as you can get, but it's what's on the inside is just amazing.
Just the little tiny things underneath.
You did that?
Yeah.
Well, the reason why I gave them to him as a gift, the reason why I did is a lot of people, when you walk in here, you just want to like say, oh, because you don't know if it's a 29 Duesenberg or
a nice
1961 Rolls Royce Cloud, Silver Cloud 2. So, and what we did down here, we did the arches with the mirrors. If there was, well, our favorite restaurant has that, so we like that. It's elegant.
Well, it makes a statement, though. You stand back here and you look down here and you see this.
Went through all upstairs.
Yeah.
I'll go through and give you a little sleep.
Good. No, that would be great.
We got the pictures of Rolls Royce and stuff and different heads of them and different badges and stuff.
Then it's Mercedes and all this stuff.
Then
we gotta have music. With this overlooking, you get a nice look at the cars.
Oh, you really do. You really do. Look at this. You know, what's really neat is, you know, a guy wants to do the garage and have his cars, and he knows what he wants in his cars. Awesome, beautiful pre-war Rolls Royces, as well as some of the finest post-war. And I'll tell you, hard-pressed to find three Duesenbergs this elegant sitting next to each other. To really find and bring home mementos of the different places you've gone for events for cars and traveled, and it's so fun, you know. They always look for some piece to bring back with them from wherever they go, and they definitely have an affinity for cars. I've never seen quite a collection. Steve has always been a Rolls Royce collector, and it's nice to have the spirit of ecstasy looking over you all the time. If you like models, and rare models, you have to go no further than here. All classics, from pewters to cased ones, different sizes. I'll tell you, I don't know how long it took him to try and put this collection together, but what's it like to be a car collector of this magnitude? To be able to surround yourself with all the trappings. To garner trophies like this was just done over the weekend by Steve Wolf for his amazing Duesenberg.